We promised him yesterday that he'd be a guest on our show today. So let's bring on Tony Alda. Hello, my man. How do you do? Suppose somebody said to you, Tony, you've got a half hour. Here, do a show. What kind of a show would you like to do?
And one thing that's always bothered me is the news.
It bothers a lot of people, I want to tell you.
The news is so tragic.
We couldn't possibly have a show that was only good news, could we?
That's exactly what I propose, a show that's called just that, Good News. And all it has is events that are interesting, that are current, that are developments, but that are on the positive side. I mean...
He's so small.
See?
He's got a watch.
That's his hospital tag.
My boyfriend Jordan and I.
Oh, yeah, Alex Craig, I know, yeah, the thin man told me all about it. Look, I'm terribly sorry, but I've got time to listen to the tape right now. I've got an engagement, see? Sorry.
Do you have a stereo in your car?
Yeah, I've got a stereo. I've got the greatest bleeding stereo you've ever heard. Come on.
Is this a dream?
Who's calling you?
I don't know, man. Must be a wrong number, huh?
Must be.
But he's also kind of a fun-loving, kind of childishly, devilishly entertaining kind of guy, too.
You're talking to an innocent man.
Oh, Johnny, I doubt if you were ever an innocent two-year-old.
This is about the rebirth of a love in a technological society.
We are here tonight, after all, to celebrate the birth of a man. Well, more than a man, an entertainer. Someone who I am proud to call a close, personal friend. Mrs. What's that say?
Steve Likens.
Mrs. Steve Likens.
The moment you fell inside my dreams, I realized all I had not seen. I've seen many other girls before.
Chips. Hi there, Chief.